Children, now we are solving next exercise, that is about simplification. You know that in order to simplify the numbers, we are following an order. That order is called Bodmas. In simplification, you know that there will be bracket, there will be OR function, there will be addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So all these four operations along with the brackets that will be involved in simplification question. So the order of solving that already we have studied in our you had studied in first chapter and second chapter, that Bodmas, that order should be followed when we solve the simplification question. And here, as it is decimal numbers, decimal, you have to take care that, because there's a chance for making mistakes when you solve the decimal numbers. So we move to the first question. Simplify the following. All of you look at here. Simplify. First question: 2/5 of 0.6 plus 2.4/8 minus 0.2. This is the question. So in this question, there are decimal number and there are fractions. So as we have studied the chapter decimal, it is better we want to change this fraction into decimal first, then we solve that. First of 2/5, how we change this fraction into decimal? In this chapter you studied, we divide the numerator by the denominator. So in one side I am going to divide that 2 divided by 5. 5 is bigger than 2, so we put the 0 at that time, 0 point here, point, 0 point. Then 5 fours are 20. Then we got it is 0.4. So here we write, in place of this we write 0.4 of 0.6. And plus here also 2.4 divided by 8. 2.4 division of decimal. 2.4 divided by 8. Here 2 is smaller number, so we take 24, but after decimal, so place the decimal. 8 threes are 24. So here also we got 0.3. This answer is 0.3. And minus 0.2. So now every numbers they are changed to decimal. Now we can start the solutions. Okay, 0.4 of 0.6. Of means multiplication. So we rewrite that as 0.4 into 0.6 plus 0.3 minus 0.2. Here first of function multiplication, that we have to do first, then addition, then subtraction, that is the order. So 0.46 are 0.4, 46 are 24, and here 2 decimal place, so therefore 2 decimal place answer, plus 0.3 minus 0.2. Then here we are going to add that first addition, then after subtraction. 0.24 plus 0.3. We can add here, otherwise directly you can do, but many students make mistake. Therefore, we add, then we get here 4, 5, and 0. That means 0.54. 0.54 minus 0.2. That is equal to, again we subtract, 0.54 minus 0.2. 0. 4 and 3, that means 0.34. So finally the result is 0.534. So here first we changed this fraction into decimal, then according to the Bodmas, that order of function means multiplication that we have done first, then we added that answer. After getting that answer, here we have done multiplication first, and that answer we got, that answer is added to the, this next we are doing this addition, then we got the answer, then after subtraction. In this order, in this way we solve the question. Okay, the next question is, you see all of you, question D. B is a comma, B and C, that is a comma for you, and question D I am going to solve. Okay, listen, 1/2 plus 2/4/5 bracket divided by 0.5 into 1.5 bracket minus 0.15 into 5 bracket, then divided by bracket 2.5 of 15/25 bracket close. So here each bracket, inside the bracket what is given, that we solve separately and together. Here each bracket we can solve together, because the result of this will not affect another bracket. Therefore, first we solve each bracket, and then finally we add, divide or subtract that one. Okay. So here, first of all, we change this fractions into decimals. So one upon two. That is how we change to fractions. Here I am, 1 divided by 2, divide it, 10, 0 means 5, 2's are 10, 2 5's are 10, therefore it is, that is 0.5 plus, and 5 2's are 10, 10 plus 4, 14, 14 upon 5, 14 upon 5 when we change to decimal, 5 2's are 10, 40, 5 8s are 40, means it is 2.8. This number is 2.8. Okay, then this bracket inside we solve, then divided by next already decimal only, that we write as it is. Then minus, here also it is given in decimal, 0.15 into 5 and divided by next 2.5 of this 15 upon 25, we divide and change to decimal, 15 upon 25, then 0, 0, 150, 6 times. So 0.6. Now students, all the numbers now we have changed to decimal. Now we can start solving this. 0.5 and 2.8, if we add, then we can add here 2.8 plus 0.5 is equal to 3.3. So here it is 3.3 divided by next 15 5s are 75, that we can multiply here 50 into 5. 75, 2 digits, therefore it is 0.75 divided by next subtract. Here also 15 5s are 75, 0.75 divided by the next 2.5 of 6. 25, 6 are 150, you know that. Means here 2 digits, therefore it is 1.50. So here every bracket we have solved. Now these two division and these two also division and finally subtraction. So according to the board mass, what we are doing, we want to divide these two division. These two we can perform first. This one and this one. These two things we can perform first, and both result that we can subtract. So first I am going to divide this 3.3 and 7.5. What is, students, you studied division. Division means here divisor, we should, there should not be a decimal. If a decimal is there in divisor, then we have to avoid it by multiplying by 100. So here I am going to multiply it by 100, 3.3. Here 100 we have to multiply, at that time here also we multiply by 100 and divided by 0.75 into 100. So I am going to write this in bracket, then subtract. Here also in division, we have to do the same thing. Here 2 digits, so we, here also we multiply by 100. 0.75 into 100 and 1.50 into 100. Why we are multiplying by 100? Because we want to avoid the decimal from here. Therefore, here it will be 330 divided by 75. And here minus and 75 divided by 150. Now these two division we perform first. First 330 divided by 75. Here 5 times, not 4 times. 5 4s are 20, 300, 330, 30 remainder, again 300 point, then 4. Means here after first division we got 4.4 and subtract next 75 and 150. 75 divided by 150, that means 75 divided by 150. Here we can see that 5 times. So here the after this division we got the answer 0.5. Now what is remaining, we are going to subtract this. We can subtract here 4.4 minus 0.5. is equal to 3.9. So the answer is 3.9. So in this question also, we converted fraction into decimal, then each bracket inside we have solved it, and after solving that, then we divided that, and after division we subtracted both the answer. So final answer is 3.9. I think you understood that each and every steps you have to do carefully. Otherwise, if a simple mistake means, then the full answer will be wrong. So carefully do that. Okay, now we go to the second question. First question, 4 questions are there. 2 questions already solved and 2 questions is a homework for you to practice. And next, second question also, 4 questions are there. And that second question, 2 questions I will solve and the remaining 2 will be homework for you. Okay. So we move to the second question, first one. First one, second question, first one. You listen, that also same method only, but the somewhat different numbers and other things comes. So you listen carefully how to solve this question. 7 upon 9 minus, then curly bracket, here inside the bracket, square bracket, then curly bracket, 7 upon 9 minus round bracket, 7 upon 9 minus 4 upon 9, then all bracket close, then off 1.8 minus 0.6 divided by 10. So here inside the bracket we solve that answer off. Off means that answer we multiply by 1.8, and then here after division then both answers we subtract. That is the order of solving that question. Okay, listen how we solve. First of all, we change this all fractions into decimal. 7 upon 9 so 7 divided by 9 Here we write 70 and then 7, 9 sevens are 63, then 7 again, then we continue, then if we continue the same thing, same will be that, if so we leave that here, then here we got 0.77 minus curly bracket, then here also same number, therefore 0.77 minus round bracket, here also 0.77 minus and 4 upon 9, here also we divide 4 and 9, 0 then decimal, 4 9s are 36, again 40, 36, again it is a 14, then it will continue, so we stop that from there itself, then 0.44, then round bracket close, curly bracket close, and bracket square bracket close of 1.8 minus, this division we can solve because it will not affect to the inside of the bracket, so in order to divide by 10 we put one more zero. One digit before we have to place the decimal. So 0.6. One more 6 will come. 0.06 after division. Okay, this division we have solved. And then next
square bracket 0.77 minus curly bracket 0.77 minus, and here we can subtract. 0.77 minus 0.44 means 0.33 will come. This inside the round bracket, what is written, that we are going to solve. Then answer is 0.33. Then curly bracket and square bracket of 1.8 minus 0.06. This subtraction we can do last only, because first we perform the of function, then after only we can do the subtraction. Okay. The next 0.77 minus. Now we are going to subtract this 0.77 minus 0.33. Then that answer we get 0.44. From 7 if we subtract 3, then 4. 0.44. Then this curly bracket also avoided. That is cancelled. Now of 1.8 minus 0.06. Next, here, this we subtraction we solve. Inside the bracket, everything we solve completely. Then only we can perform the next outside function. So, 0.77 minus 0.44, that is equal to 0.33. And then off, 1.8 minus 0.06. And off means it is multiplication. Therefore, we write 0.33 into 1.8 minus 0.06. Now we perform this multiplication. This one, then 33, 1.8. That decimal we avoid, then we can write. Then multiply. 3 8s are 24, remainder 2, 3 8s are 24 plus 2, 26. 3 and 3. Then we add 4, 9 and 5. Means 3 digit, total 3 decimal place, so it will be like this. So the answer of this is equal to 0.594 minus 0.06. Now we want to subtract this number, these two numbers, then subtract 0.594 minus 0.060. 4, 3 and 5. So the answer is 0.534. So here, students, you have to do it carefully, because each and every steps we have solved step by step, and converted fraction into decimals, and then bracket, every bracket we solved and avoided, and then finally we reach the of functions. So very carefully you have to do, otherwise there is a chance for mistakes. So each and every step, when you solve the multiplication and division, should be carefully done. Okay, so now we move to this last question of this chapter. Old question C of that. That's a long question, and it involves bracket. All types of bracket are there, and of functions and division, everything is there. So let us solve this question once, and you carefully listen. So here, first of all, we do that. This will be converted to decimals. 3.46 of, that of we write here, and when we convert this to decimal, we can see that 4, 5 is 20, 23 divided by 5, 5 4 is 20 and 3, 6, 30, so it is 4.6 divided by, then bracket starts. 23.678 minus curly bracket 15.62 plus square bracket, round bracket 3.5 minus, this we change to decimal, then it will be 3.2. We can divide and find out that you can 3.2 plus 0.2, and here line bracket and round bracket close, curly bracket close, and square bracket also close. Okay, now we are going to solve this. 3.46 of, that of function we must do first, of 4.6, then divided by next square bracket 23.678 minus curly bracket 15.62 plus round bracket 3.5. And here we can add. First, in all the bracket, first we want to solve what is written under the line bracket or bar bracket. 3.2 plus 0.2 is equal to 3.4. That is 3.4. We can add here 3.2, 0.2 plus. Then it will be 3.4. So here, we got 3.4 answer. Then curly bracket also close and square bracket also close. The next step, here we can multiply this O function. That multiplication we can do because this is outside the bracket, it will not affect the answer of this bracket. Therefore, we can multiply it 3.46 into 4.6. This we are going to multiply. 6 are 36, remainder 3. 4 6 are 24 plus 3, 27, remainder 2. 3 6 are 18 plus 2, 20. 6 4s are 24, remainder 2, 4 4s are 16 plus 2, 18, and remainder 1, 3 4s are 12 plus 1, 13. 6. So here are 3 decimal places, so 15.916. 15.916 divided by the bracket we write 23.678 minus curly bracket 15.62 plus 3.5 minus 3.4 is equal to 0.1. 0.1. You can subtract here 3.5 minus 3.4 is equal to 0.1. Then curly bracket, round bracket is already solved, that answer we got. Then curly bracket and square bracket. Next step. 15.916 divided by 23.678 minus, this we are solving, 15.62 plus 0.1, 15.62 plus 0.1, 2, 7 and 15, 15.72. 15.72. Curly bracket also no need because already we solved this. Next, this square bracket 15.916 divided by 23.678 and 15.72. We subtract 23.678 minus 15.720. We get 8 is equal to 5, then 9 is equal to 7. That is equal to 7.958. So now this bracket also over. Now this division. In order to divide, you know that we have to multiply here 3 decimal places, so multiply by 1000. Here also 3 decimal places, so multiply by 1000. So the point will be multiplied by 1000, point will shift to here and here also shifted here. That is equal to 15916 divided by 7958. So we divide that. Here we can divide that 15916 divided by 7958. Here you can see that it is 2 times 7958 into 2. 8 2s are 16. 2 times, so 7958 into 2 is equal to 15,960. So 0. Therefore, here finally we got a 2. So students, this is a question that involves every type of a fraction. That means there is a subtraction, there is addition, and there is multiplication of and division and all types of bracket also involved in this question. Now I think that you understood that how to simplify a number and what is the order we have to follow to simplify these numbers and everything you understood now. And now the remaining two questions, that's a homework for you. Total in second question simplification, four questions are there. We have solved two questions and two questions remaining. That's a homework for you. And first question also two questions remaining. First simplification, first question, two questions remaining. That's also a homework for you. So students, our this fourth chapter has completed. So once again you revise this chapter from the beginning itself. Many things we studied in this chapter, like decimals, addition, subtraction, multiplication and divisions, and also word problems and how to simplify when all these functions comes together. So all about all the things that we studied, all the points we studied, these points you once you revise and practice. I told before also there will be a class test, so I will announce you the time to for the class test. So students, now it is a time to stop today's class. So I think that what we have learned today, that all you understood, and also I hope that all are doing your works properly and regularly, and your work is has completed and it is up to date. So if not, then you have to complete your works as soon as possible, and daily your whatever work you are getting, that you do in the same day itself, so that your work will be finished and you will be updated about the subject. So students, I am stopping the class today. Okay, thank you everybody and have a nice day to everyone. Thank you.